my daughter Charlotte had meningococcal septicaemia in December 2010. Charlotte was nearly three. My mum and my sister had looked after her that day. Absolutely fine, normal, nothing untoward. About 10 o'clock, she woke up and was very, very sick, but very quickly, and just settled straight back to sleep. So I just assumed that it was just one of the sickness bugs going around. I just kept an eye on her. I gave her some Calpol, and it just appeared that she was asleep. My coat, my bag, ready to go to work. And I just checked her, and she just had three really small purple sort of spots on her chest. And I immediately ran and got a glass. I rolled it over the spots, they didn't fade. And then by that point, because I thought, I was alarmed then, and I called an ambulance. The patrol car came, and he checked Charlotte's vital signs, and obviously then called for the backup ambulance. The ambulance lady, you know, said, hold Charlotte in your arms. And I think that was because she just didn't actually know if Charlotte was going to make it or not. And then by the time we got to the hospital, those three pinpricks had turned, you know, into like a rash all over her body. And I saw the illness take over, like her eyes turned a funny colour. They went from white to like yellow, and I just saw everything take over. The staff was waiting at the John Ratcliffe, and it was just from there, it was like a real, real emergency fight, you know, for Charlotte's life. She was in hospital for 6 weeks, but she was in intensive care for 16 days. Her arms and legs were covered in bandages, and she was obviously very limited with that, and she was sort of sweating terribly because obviously her limbs had died off and they needed to be removed, and she was probably, I'd say, better after having the operation. She actually was, I'd say, healthier, and that was the start of her recovery. When we first brought Charlotte home, we were thinking just there and then to look after, like, every day, what does she need? You know, we had to make sure we had lots of healthy food because her body was recovering. Her the ends of her legs, most commonly, you know, they would bleed. It was constant nurses coming out, changing dressings. We've had our whole life just go from a normal life where we were meant to go on our first holiday, and you know, our child is then completely seriously ill, disabled overnight. We had to both leave work, so financially, you know, we were in a lot of difficulty, you know, and we're still finding it's very hard when you have a disabled child who has had 10 general anaesthetics in under 2 years since leaving hospital. We've now found out that Charlotte does need specially made lower limbs, and they cost, the first pair have cost £6,000, and they last up to 12 months, but can, you know, need changing after like 9 months if she has a growth spurt. We're trying to be a positive family and sort of do the best we can, but obviously we have long-term financial concerns, and the effect on Charlotte's younger brother George is now becoming more apparent because he's had to see his sister go through all this trauma over the last 2 years, and he gets very anxious and upset and is obviously affected by the whole family ordeal that we've had to suffer. It's only after 2 years now that she is really, you know, getting back to her normal self. I think there's lots of things people don't realise. It's a real sort of physical and mental and emotional sort of recovery from the illness. Obviously, to find out about the possibility of the vaccine being out there soon was, you know, very mixed emotions for myself. I was, of course, very, very pleased that it could save lives and stop all these terrible things happening, you know, the after effects of disabilities from the illness. But it's bittersweet as well, because I know myself, you know, I think what could have been for Charlotte if she had not suffered this illness.